ghost nets had unintentionally lost fishing gear. They are found on the open sea or in the waters. It's still passive fishing. Fishes are swimming in because no one comes there to pick it up again. Before 2018, I was very unhappy because we didn't find the nets. I was reading about Creighton and his work, and actually the technology he's using, side scan sonar technology, gives us the possibility to search on huge areas for these lost ghost nets.
Because I started 40-odd years ago, I got to get involved in searching for a lot of different items, planes, trains, subs, nets. When the Columbia space shuttle was lost, and I was contacted in finding the black box, my failure rate is typically less than 5%.
Creighton is an expert about side-scan sonar. He has superhuman eyes, eyes that can find nets designed to be invisible in the water.
Detecting a ghost net is all about pattern recognition.
And if we find something like here, I mark it.
Some people you just couldn't teach to do it, period.
Now, with Microsoft AI, with the GhostNetZero AI, we can scale his knowledge.
So we are always looking for partners, and WWF had an amazing problem that is trying to look for ghost nets on the ocean. An expert human can find a ghost net from a sonar, but it's challenging, and it would take hundreds of years to go through all of this sonar data and review it.
So with the AI, we just multiply Creighton in the easiest words.
In order for us to have an impact, we need these ghost nets being retrieved. So that relationship between divers and us is critical. Without that relationship, this doesn't work.
There are a lot of small groups working together on one problem, and if everybody puts their power together, then maybe this problem will be solved in the future.
I need to be optimistic. I have two kids. I want that they see nature, that they see ocean, and we have to care for that. I hope we can show that the connection between persons which see the actual problem and the tech world can help us to solve more problems for our planet.